The Monkey Ace got a rework which buffed the X1X crosspaths and changed the Spectre to better handle Super Ceramics. Starting with the Exploding Pineapples crosspath, it now buffs the Pierce of the top path missiles and bottom path bombs. This is a nice change as it makes the middle crosspath more competitive, but it still should only be taken when external camo detection is not possible. As the Sky Shredder benefits more from the extra pierce of the bottom path, and the Flying Fortress benefits more from the increased attack speed and pierce of the top crosspath. Now onto the fun Spectre changes. The 004 Spectre got its dart and bomb pierce cut in half, however, they both got +2 damage to ceramics. This was to incentivize the new 014 crosspath's extra pierce while also allowing it to carry better into the late game against super ceramics. The Spectre used to really struggle against these, but this new extra damage helps mitigate that, giving you a little extra time to get your tier 5 towers up and running. When it comes to which crosspath to go on the Spectre, the choice is clear. Get a 024 Spectre if you need camo detection, and get a 204 otherwise. This is because the 024 only gives camo detection and +50% pierce to the Spectre's bombs, but the 204 provides an extra 33% attack speed and +25% pierce to each dart. And we've learned from other videos that the extra damage benefits faster attacking towers much more. Overall, this is a buff to the Spectre even though the pierce was cut in half, and the damage to the ceramics was only buffed by 80%. Now I know that the pierce is helpful for every balloon type, and this extra damage is only for ceramics, but super ceramics were its biggest weakness, and this extra damage is what it needed more than anything. Add to the fact that it doesn't utilize its max pierce most of the time, and balloons below ceramics are basically irrelevant by the time you have a Spectre. And you can clearly see that this is a great change. But let me know what you guys think down in the comments.